हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर चैनल। आई एम आशन्ना, डायरेक्टर ऑफ साधन स्टडी सर्किल। आई हैव बीन टीचिंग मैथमेटिक्स लास्ट 6 इयर्स। फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई वुड लाइक टू टीच यू एक्सपोनेंट्स। इन दिस एक्सपोनेंट्स वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न एक्सपोनेंशियल फॉर्म, बेस एक्सपोनेंट, एक्सपांडेड फॉर्म, स्क्वेर्ड, क्यूब्ड, writing a number in exponential form through prime factorization, loss of exponents. Let us learn one by one. First one, exponential form or base or exponents. What is an exponential form? Base and exponents, let us observe. When a number is multiplied by itself for many number of times, it can be written in short form. That is called exponential form. As under 5 into 5 into 5 into up to into 5 20 times, it can be written in short 5 to the power of 20. So this short form 5 to the power of 20 is called exponential form. This is a exponential form. In this, 5 is called base. 5 is called base. 20 is called exponent. In detail, 5 to the power of 20 is called exponential form. 5 is called the base. And 20 is called the exponent. One more example, a into a up to m times is equal to a to the power of m. This a to the power of m is a short form, is called exponential form. The factor which multiplied itself again and again is called base. The number of times, here m times, number of times the factor appears is called exponent. Exponent is also called power or index. Power or index. Power or index is equal to m. base is equal to a to the power of m is the exponential form. Expanded form of a given number in exponential form. What is an expanded form? Number expanded by its places is called expanded form. But here we have to expand it in exponential form. To understand, here we have an example. Let us observe. Once 36,584. First, we have to indicate the name of the places: ones, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands. Three ten thousands are. Place 6,000 to give clarity, we may keep a bracket also. 6,000 plus 500 plus 8 tens plus 4 ones This is a expanded form, but we have to write in exponential form. 3 × 10⁴ plus 6 × 10³ plus 5 × 10⁺ 8 × 10⁹ 4 × 1 only, or we can write 10⁰. This is the exponential form. Squared and cubed. What is a square? If a number is multiplied by itself, then the product is called square of that number. Let us observe one example. Square of 5 we have to multiply itself twice. 5 square 5 5 25 25, we can write to 5 square, so we can read as 5 raised to the power of 2 or 5 raised to the power 2 or 5 to the power of 2 or 5 to the power 2. In short, 5 squared. These many ways we can read 5 to the power of 2. Cubed. What is a cube? If a number is multiplied by thrice itself, then the product is called cube of that number. Example, cube of 5 is equal to 5 into 5 into 5 is equal to 5 to the power of 3. This 5 to the power of 3 is called cubed, 5 cubed. We can read as 5 raised to the power of 3 or 5 raised to the power 3 or 5 raised to the power of 5 to the power of 3 or 5 to the power 3. In short, 5 cubed. We can read it these many ways. This is the short form, 5 cubed. Here we have to know few numbers and their squares, cubes. Square of 1, 1 1's are 1. Square of 2, 2 2's are 4. 3 3's are 9. 4 4's are 16. 5 5's are 25. 6 6's are 36. 7 7's are 49. 8 8's are 64. 9 9's are 81. 10 10's are 100. 11 11's are 121. 12 12's are 144. 13 13's are 169. 14 14's are 196. 15 15's are 225. 16 16's are 256. 17 17's are 289. 18 18's are 324. 19 19's are 361. 20 20's are 400. 21 21's are 441. 22 22's are 484. 23 23's are 529. 24 24's are 576. 25 25 25's are 625. These are standard squares. Next, number and its cube. 1 cube 1 1's are 1 1 1's are 1. 2 cube 2 2's are 4 4 2's are 8. 3 cube 3 3's are 9 9 3's are 27. 4 cube 4 4's are 16 16 4's are 64. 5 cube 5 5's are 25 25 5's are 125. 6 cube 6 6's are 36 36 6's are 216. 7 cube 7 7's are 49 49 7's are 4 343. 8 cube 8 8 is 64 64 8's are 512. 9 cube 9 9's are 81 81 9's are 729. 10 10 10 cube 10 10's are 100 100 10's are 1000. These also standard cubes, these standard squares, these standard cubes. Writing a number in exponential form through prime factorization. Let us express the following numbers in exponential form using prime factorization. 432. while finding prime factors, we have to take only prime numbers, 2 table, 2 2s, 2 1s, 2 6, 2 1s, 2 0s, 2 8s, 2 5s, 2 4s, 2 2s, 2 7s, here 1 remainder, 2 7s are 14, next to 3s, 9s, 27, 3 3s, so 432 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. So 2, so how many? 1, 2, 3, 4. 2 to the power of 4 into 3 cube. So this is the exponential form using prime factorization method. Next, one more problem here, 450, 2 table, 2 2s, 2 2s are 4, 1 remainder, 2 5s are 10, 2 1s are, not divisible by 2, this 2 plus 2, this is odd number, that's why this is not divisible by 2, that's why we have to try next to prime, 3, 2, 2, 4, 4 plus 5, 9. So, it is exactly divisible by 3. Sum of the digits is 9. So, that's why it is divisible by 3. 3 7s are 21, 1 remainder, 3 5s are 15. Next to 7 plus 5, 12. So, it is again divisible by 3. 3 2s are 6, 3 5s are 15. Now not divisible by 3, 2 plus 5, 7, because 2 plus 5, 7, that's why not divisible by 3. Next, it is divisible by 5, because 5 in one's place, there is a 5. 5, 5 is a 25. 450 is equal to 2 into 3 into 3 into 5 into 5. So 2, 1, 2 only, 3 is 2. 3 square, so 5 square. So this is the exponential form for 450 by using prime factorization method. Loss of exponents. In this loss of exponents, first one, multiplying terms with the same base. To understand this, here we have one example, 2 to the power of 4 into 2 to the power of 3 is equal to 2 to the power of 4. So here we have to write 4 times, and 2 to the power of 3 3 times. Here we have written 4 times. Here we have written 3 times. That is equal to 2 to the power of 4 plus 3 is 7. And this is same as 2 to the power of 4 plus 3. Basing this, we can write one more directly. This is example 1. Example 2. 5 to the power of 4 into 5 to the power of 7 is equal to, this is 5 to the power of 4, this is 5 to the power of 7. So 5 to the power of 4 plus 7 is equal to 5 to the power of 11. By observing these two examples, we can write a formula, a to the power of m into a to the power of n is equal to a to the power of m plus n exponent of exponent. To understand this, let us take an example. 2 to the power of 3 whole to the power of 5. Exponent of exponent. We have to write 2 to the power of 3 5 times. 2 to the power of 3 into 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 2 to the power of 3. So I have written 5 times. So we know the first formula. Basing this, we can add this 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. 2 to the power of 3 5 is 15. 15, 2 to the power of 15. Basing this, we can write directly example 2. Five to the power of 2 whole to the power of 3, and same as and this is same as 3 5s are 2 to the power of 3 5s are. So we can write like this: 5 to the power of 2 3s are 5 to the power of 2 3s are 6. Basing these two examples, we can write directly as a formula: a to the power of m whole to the power of n is equal to a to the power of mn. We are learning laws of exponents. In this laws of exponents, this is the third one, same exponent of a product. Here we have same exponents. Bases are different. We can expand this 2 5 times, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. And 3 into 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. We can make pairs 2 and 3s. One, two, three, four. Two into two, these are five pairs. We got five pairs. We can write this 2 into 3 5 times. So we can write 2 into 3 to the power of 5. So we understood 2 into 3. Whole to the power of 5, we can write answer also. 2 3 is 6 to the power of 5. But up to here, observing, and this is the same as 2 into 3 whole to the power of 5. 2 into 3 whole to the power of 5. By observing this, we can write directly example 2: 5 to the power of 3 into 2 to the power of 3 is equal to 5 into 2 whole to the power of 3, 5 2s are 10 to the power of 3. We can write final answer also. 10,000. But observing up to here, we can write a formula. A to the power of m into b to the power of m is equal to ab all to the power of m. This is the formula. Same exponents of a product. Same exponent of a product. Division of exponents. Before discussing division of exponents, we have to discuss negative exponents. Let us observe few patterns to understand this. 2 to the power of 5 is equal to 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16, 16 to the 32. 2 to the power of 4 is equal to 16. 2 cube is equal to 8. 2 square is equal to 4. 2 to the power of 1 is equal to 2. 2 to the power of 0 is equal to 1. 2 to the power of minus 1 is equal to half of this 1 by 2. 2 to the power of minus 2 is equal to 1 by 4. 2 to the power of minus 3 is equal to 1 by 8. Now we are taking one more pattern. 3 to the power of 5. 3 threes are 9, 9 threes are 27, 27 threes are 81, 81 threes are 243. 3 to the power of 4 is equal to 3 threes are 9, 9 threes are 27, 27 threes are 81. 3 cube is equal to 27. 3 square is equal to 9. 3 to the power of 1 is equal to 3. 3 to the power of 0 is equal to 1. 3 to the power of minus 1 is equal to 1/3. This is a 3 times, this is a 1/3. 3 to the power of minus 2 is equal to 1 by 9. 1 by 9. 3 to the power of minus 3 is equal to 1 by 27. So like this we can continue. If we observed this, we can get one idea. 1 by 2. So here, first here we can observe 2 square. Here we have minus 2, 2 to the power of minus 2. We got in denominator 2 to the power of 2. Here 1 by 2 cube, 8 to 2 cube. So we can write now this 2 to the power of 1. And also we can write here 1 by 3 to the power of 1, 1 by 3 square, 1 by 3 cube, 27 3 cube. By observing these two examples, we can conclude a to the power of minus n is equal to 1 by a to the power of n. So this is the formula. Negative exponents. This is the negative exponents. We can write 1 by a to the power of n. Next, zero exponents. Zero exponents. We already got this 2 to the power of 0, 1. 3 to the power of 0 also got 1. 4 to the power of 0, we can write 1. 5 to the power of 0, also 1. So like this, if there is a zero exponent, we can write 1. So a to the power of 0 also, for any number a, a to the power of 0 is equal to 1. Division of exponents having the same base. Here we have three examples. In all these exams, same bases 7, 7, 3, 3, 5, 5. So we can observe these examples. Seven to the power of 5. We have to write 7 5 times. 7, 7, 7, 7, 7 by 7 3 times 7, 7. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 is equal to 7 square. Is same as, which is same as 5 minus 3. So 7 to the power of 5 minus 3. Because here we have 5, 3, 5 minus 3, we get 2. Next, 3 square by 3 to the power of 8. 3, 2 times, 8 times, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 times, 1, 2, 1, 2. So this is equal to 1 by 3 to the power of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 3 to the power of 6, which is same as 1 by 3 to the power of 8 minus 2, because 8 minus 2 is equal to 6. That's why 3 to the power of 8 minus 2. Next, so third example, 5 to the power of 4, 5, 5, 4 times, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is equal to 1, which is same as 5 to the power of 4 minus 4. 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. 4 minus 4 is equal to 0. So that is equal to 5 to the power of 0. 5 to the power of 0. So here 5 to the power of 0. So 1. By observing these three examples, we can write a to the power of m in a to the power of m divided by a to the power of n is equal to, in first case, a to the power of m minus m, a to the power of m minus n. Here m is greater than n, if m is greater than n. This is first one. And second, a to the power of m by a to the power of n is equal to 1 by a to the power of n minus m. So this second case, 8 minus 2, 8 minus 2. So if m is less than n or n is greater than m. Both the same meaning. Next, third, a to the power of m by a to the power of n is equal to 1. If m is equal to n, this is the, in third case, if there are same exponents, we can get one only if m is equal to n. So these we understood from those three examples. Dividing terms with the same exponents. To understand this, here we have an example. 7 by 4 whole to the power of 5. We can write this 7 by 4 5 times. Now we can write a product of numerators by product of denominators. 5 times, 4 5 times. By definition of exponent, we can write short form 7 to the power of 5 by 4 to the power of 5. What we get 7 to the power of 5 by 4 to the power of 5. 7 by 4 whole to the power of 5 is equal to, we got this. By observing this, we can write one more example directly. 3 to the power of 3 by 9, 3 by 8 whole to the power of 9 is equal to 3 to the power of 9 by 8 to the power of 9. By observing these two examples, we can write a formula. For any non-zero integer, a and b, a by b whole to the power of m is equal to a to the power of m by b to the power of m. Terms with negative base. To understand this, we have to observe a few examples. One to the power of 3 is equal to 1 into 1 into 1 is equal to 1. 1 square is equal to 1 into 1 is equal to 1. 1 to the power of 1 is equal to 1. Minus 1 whole to the power of 3 is equal to minus 1 into minus 1 is equal to minus 1 is equal to minus into minus plus, plus into minus, minus, minus 1. Minus 1 whole square is equal to minus 1 into minus 1 is equal to minus into minus plus. Minus 1 whole to the power of 1 is equal to minus 1. So minus 1. And also we have to write minus 1 whole to the power of 4. Minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 is equal to minus into minus plus, plus into minus, minus, minus into minus plus, plus 1. So what we understood, 1 is raised to any power, 1 is raised to any power is 1 only, we observed. second minus 1 is raised to minus 1 is raised to odd power is minus 1. Minus 1 is raised to odd power is minus 1. This is odd power. This is also odd power. So we got minus 1. Next, minus 1 is raised to even power is minus 1 is raised to even power is minus 1 whole to the power of 2 even power is minus 1 whole to the power of even power minus 1 whole to the power of 6. These are even powers. Plus 1. This is also plus 1. This is also plus 1. So minus 1 is raised to even power is plus 1 or 1. By observing these examples, we can understand minus 1 whole to the power of m. Here a is any non-zero integer. M is any number. So then a minus a whole to the power of m is equal to minus a to the power of m. If m is odd. Minus a whole to the power of m is equal to a to the power of m if m is even. Expressing large numbers in standard form. To express large numbers in standard form or scientific notation, here we have a concept. Let us observe. In standard form or scientific notation, a number is expressed as the product of large integer exponent of 10 and a decimal number between 1 and 10. Here we have one example. The mass of the earth is about 5976 × 10^21 kg. Here we have 5976, but we have to write this large integer exponent of 10 and a decimal number between 1 and 10. Here we have to make a decimal number between 1 and 10. To make 1 between 1 and 10, we have to shift the decimal to the left by 1, 2, 3 places. A whole number or integral part left right of the decimal point. So here we have the decimal points. That's why we have to shift 3 places to the left. 1, 2, 3. To shift the decimal point to the 3 places, we have to multiply the number by 1000. So 5.976 × 10^21 × 10^1000. 1000 means 10^3. So final answer is 5.976 × 10^ here bases same bases, so power should be at 21 + 3 = 24 kg. So this is the final answer. Next, second example. The universe is estimated to be about 12 billions, ones, tens, hundreds, thousand, 10,000, 100,000, million, 10 million, 100 million, billion, 10 billions. So 12 billions years old. So this is the largest number, larger number. So we have to keep this number, decimal number between 1 and 10. So here 12, so we have to keep the decimal point here. 3 zeros, 6 zeros, 9 zeros, 10. We have to shift the decimal point to the left by 10 places. So that's why we have to multiply 12 here we have to keep the decimal point into 10 to the power of 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So years old. So no value for this. Final answer 1.2 into 10 to the power of 10 years old. So this is the final answer. Thank you, children. Thank you for watching my video. If you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe and press the bell icon to get my latest updates. And also share it to your friends to help them and encourage for me to make more interesting videos.